We are very lucky to be out on Niel's boat today. We're going to go after some big conger. Rigs are ready. Baits is ready. We're going to stop off on the way out to try and get some fresh pouting, some whiting, and then we're going to flapper them up and we're going to try and luck on a wreck. Fingers crossed, the day goes well. I'm sure it will. We're out on a boat, so it's a good day as it is. Should be a nice flat, calm morning, but we'll know when we're out the gate. We've got the panther right behind us. So where that bridge is open. Ryan's a good skipper. He knows where the fish is, but then I think hopefully so do we. But yeah, lovely. Right, let's go. So we've been set free from the lock, you know, the two best fishermen in Eastbourne. Scenery's gorgeous, sea's looking nice, and what more could you want? One thing I have got is work later on, which is unfortunate, but that's not until 5 o'clock, so we should probably get about at least 6 hours fishing in, which isn't too bad. So once again, huge thanks to Niel, and let's go and hit some fish. So what you've caught me doing is I'm just chopping up a few bits of squid and just putting them on some sabikis. We're just going to try and feather down some pout and some whiting for the live bait and the flapper baits for the congers. So nice little trace with a few bits of squid on. Nice and simple. We're going to get a weight on the end and we'll drop it down. Yep, we're in. There we go, we're in something already. Should be some big pouting. As I said, literally that was just on the drop. First time, easy. Nothing complicated on this boat. All nice and simple. There we go, that's our first conger bait. Perfect size. Get in. We're gonna get 10, 15. And yeah, jobs are good. First bait. We're into another pout, which is exactly what we want, believe it or not. It's not normally, but we need some bait. We have got some bait, but that's a nice size. It's little, but that's perfect. Good for a live bait. Get it in the tank, get it back out then. Niels into a fish or two. Oh, my rod's going.
And this is the big one.
Oh, jumbo.
Is it a
jumbo? Oh, bream.
Look at that. That was unexpected.
That's your dinner.
Unexpected.
Lovely.
Lovely.
Nice bream. That's what that shell was then.
Yeah.
Oh, look at the finder's full of them, mate.
Yeah.
Oh, here we go. I've got bites. Here we go.
Lovely.
Yeah. Can't go wrong with that.
getting all sorts.
All sorts. All right, Niel's into another little fish. Fighting a bit more than a pout might do.
Oh, it's a dogfish.
Oh, it's a dogfish. Well, it wouldn't be a trip without one of them, would it? Mr. Doggy. We're into a big fish. I thought it was a snag, and it's quite, I reckon it might be a conger. Might be a conger. What the devil is going on? I'm just going to put my small hooks on to bring up more little pout. And we're into a big one. Well, I say big, it's only a light lure setup, light rod, so it might not be massive, but it'll be something nice. Nearly took the rod in, didn't it?
Yeah.
Nearly took the rod in.
The devil's in.
Here we go. What is it, a big dogfish?
No, it's a cod.
It's a cod.
Codling. Lovely codling. Look at that.
Cod.
Oh, my God. Wow. It's a unicorn. It's a unicorn.
We like unicorns out here, don't we? That was unexpected. Look at that.
Look at that.
Flippin' heck.
Gee whiz.
Well, you don't see many of those about.
I'll tell you what, I am excited.
That is good, isn't it?
Yeah, you don't see one of them often.
Could be a good year for them. Fantastic. I'm going to take him for dinner, I think, actually. Don't rarely get them, so I think it's deserved. Fantastic, just on a little sabiki on the bottom with a bit of squid baited out. Wow, on slack water as well. Could be a great day's fishing. Well, it will be. We've had a great day, haven't we?
It's so far.
Excellent. We're into another fish. I think it might just come off. I think it just come off. Let's have a look. Yeah, it did. A little bit bigger. There might have been another codling. Excellent. All we need now is a 30-40 pound conger later, and we've really smashed it. Plan. I like it when a plan goes to action. It doesn't normally, so it's nice when it does. But saying that, it has on this boat every time so far. So. We're in, boys, we're in. It's ridiculous. It's slack water, we're drifting at like 0.2 knots. Not even quick. I think it's dogfish. Yeah, dogfish. It wouldn't be a trip without a dogfish each. So, not going to bring him over the side because he'll spit.
Doggy in the boat.
Doggy in the boat. That's right. There you go. Little dogfish. We're just going to rerun a drift over that local reef that we're on now and see what we can just pick up. What we're doing is we're waiting for the tide to pick up. And then we shall go out to the wreck and try for conger. But for anchoring a wreck and for conger, you need a bit of tide. So we've probably got about another half an hour, 40 minutes of this, and then we'll go out to the wreck, which is known for big conger, and we'll take our baits out there and we shall go and give it a go. That's the idea anyway. What do we think scores on the doors are going to be?
Mr.
Pout. Finally. Oh, my rod's going. Oh, goodness me. Rod's going again.
It's all going off.
It's all going off. Oh, goodness me. What have we got here then? Oh. That's probably the bottom, isn't it? Oh, no. We'll try and get him out in a minute. It's because we've got a bit of tide now. Oh, damn it. Oh, sugar. Oh, he's off. Oh, two big pout, look at that. There we go, two big pout for us, that's good. Right, we've got one last drift on this reef. Get a couple more pout in, hopefully maybe some edible eating size bream. And then we're gonna go and head to go and get some big congers. Hopefully. What a day so far. What a day. Right, so I'm on my knees, not for any weird reason. I'm actually making up the chum we're gonna put out. And we're not shark fishing, but conger love a scent. So we've got a load of dead hardbacks. We've got mackerel. I've got 10 place fillets, and we put it all in this bag in here. I'll open it up and show you quickly before we stick the pick in. I don't know if you can see inside there. Lovely jubbly. Load of smelly old fish and a load of oil. Right, we're gonna get the anchor in and then we're gonna get fishing for some big conger, hopefully. Might get some bycatch as well. Red anchor, took us two goes, but we got it in the end. We're probably still, you know, a little bit off, but we're gonna draw them out. We've got a load of chum down there, so that should be good. Flapping it up, a pouting. As you can see, bigger through the front, and then we've just cut out the middle. A load of guts left in and flapped like that. So, weight on the bottom and then it kind of just slides up the trace. So any signal of a bite, we should see it. Right, let's hit the cast out and get fishing.
Oh, he's on, yes. Yeah,
bite.
Excellent.
See, I'm sorting out Neil's rod for him, and he's catching all the fish. Yeah, that's what it's about. Look at this bed.
That's what we want.
That's what we're after.
That's what we come here for.
Took a bit of time, but we're... Oh, he's pulling up now, isn't he? Oh, I've got a bite. Oh, I've got a bite. Oh, no. Got a bite on mine. That's on the pout flapper. I'm going to let him take it a bit. Now, the lovely bit about this is we're on sand, so the likelihood of them getting into snags is quite low. There is a wreck, obviously, which we're fishing sort of near, but not quite on. I've got a lovely bite on that. Might have to clip this camera up and have a feel.
Yeah, that's a good bite. That's
yeah.
A good bite.
Here we go. Right. Oh, here we go. The boys are... Boys are going to be hauling today. Oh, I can feel him. I feel him having a check the drag. Yeah, we're in. We're in. We're in. This is a nice fish.
Oh. Here he comes. Here he comes.
This is what it's about now.
Here he comes. Here he comes.
He's righty.
Yeah.
There we go. We've got Niel's conger down there. Lovely, well done, Niel. And I've got mine on here. Clip your boys up. Oh. We've been here for a couple of minutes. The location that we scouted earlier. And we're fishing it. We're in 8-6 foot of water. See him coming in. There he is, just a strap really. That shows the rig's working. There we go. See you later, boy. Put it there, my friend. Conger each, flan come in. Right, we're in again, boys. I was just sorting out Niel's rod. And, oh, has it come off? No, he hasn't, he's still on. Or is he still on? Yeah, he's still on, he's coming up in the water. And off it went.
You got him?
Yeah, he's still there.
What do you reckon that is?
He don't feel like a conger. He's coming in a bit too easy now, but he might be. He might just be coming up in the water. Oh no, it's a little strap.
Oh, is it?
Little strap. Oh, he put up on. He took the rod in, didn't he? Little strap eel. Where's that T-bar gone? Lovely, cheers. Right, one eel, obviously it's not got a lot of weight on it, so it's a small weight to knock it off, because with a T-bar you're using the weight of the fish to get the hook out. Problem is, he needs to stop spinning before I can get it in there. All right, what hook have I got? There you go. Down he goes. Hi, Mr. Conger. Excellent. So we've had I've had two conger eels. Neil's had one conger eel. We've had cod, we've had bream, pout, fabulous, and today's only just started, so we got good on the spot. Right, let's get another bait on. There you go, boys, here you go.
It's all going, mate.
It's all a go.
Going off, all going off, all isn't it?
Oh. Niel was taking off his jumper, his rod went, I had to grab his rod. I was sorting out my tackle box on the floor. Oh no! Or has he come up? No, he's still there. He's coming up in the water, right? Yeah, there he is. Oh, they really swim up quick. There we go. A boat and a conger. There he is.
Biggest one so far.
So far, yes, we got.
Biggest one so far.
There he is.
They're nicely hooked as well.
Yeah, they're easy to do, do, aren't they?
Nicely hooked.
There we go. Nicely done, fella. Nice. Woohoo!
They're all going.
They're all off.
Oh my god. Which one do I take?
Which one
do
choice.
I take? They're all going.
a shot.
Yes, there we go. He's in. He's in. Neil's arrow rod's going. Oh,
this
dear.
Is a bigger one, I think.
Yeah.
That's it, Neil's into it. That rod's going, I should probably take that if that goes.
Yeah.
Viewers, keep an eye on them three here. I'm gonna strike into this one, which keeps going. Make sure it's not on. Yeah.
Fish is on the side there.
Oh yeah. Oh yeah, there we go. Two fisherholics into two congers. We've got pretty much two other rods going there as well. Yeah, take a look at this. Two eels. And two gentle gentlemen. Oh dear. Good job we got two T-bars. Yeah, that's a mackerel flapper I've just put out. Look at that. Bam, bam, bam. Let's investigate it.
I'll stick you on here. Oh yeah, here we go. Get that rod out the holder.
My one's going now, Jake.
Oh, they're back again.
Mm.
Oh, just as you sit down for a sandwich is always the way,
yeah.
Isn't it? Oh, no, he's in. He's there, he's there, he's there. Only a small one, I think. Oh, I think it's just a small conger, this one. Little small one. Might have even popped off, but might be a dogfish, I suppose, but I don't know, actually. Well, I think he's come off. But we'll carry on winding, because they're... Oh, no, something's there. Oh my goodness, a bream. A bream.
Oh, that's lovely. Hold him.
Yeah. Ready? Hey, there he goes.
Lovely.
Big bream on a probably size, 5'4" hook, I suppose. Greedy bugger. I didn't think it was a conger when I struck into him. Yeah, he's alright, isn't he?
Yeah.
Not bad at all. He must be a good pound, isn't he?
Hmm.
Lovely, happy days. He's right, isn't he?
Good.
Yeah, got him. Ooh, say I've got him. Oh, I did have him. I did have him, but not anymore. All right, calm down, little one. You're going home for Neil's tea. What a day. November, and we're still getting big bream.
Lovely.
It's mental. Well, I got a third of the way through, and now I'm two thirds of the way through, and Neil's got a fish. Just cannot finish these crisps. It's always a way when you're fishing. You have a sandwich and the bites come on. But to be fair, it's been bites non-stop today.
Well, that's an eel, I think. I'm sure it's an eel.
Look at those arms, he's a powerhouse. Put it out.
Or was it a dogfish?
Was it a dogfish?
It's a dogfish.
Excellent.
First one of the day. Well, first one on anchor.
There you go. My little doggy. Got a fish on here. Don't know what it is yet. Might be a small eel. Ah, he's a tiny little scrap.
He's
like a baby.
This one's on it. They're all going.
Oh, Neil's clicker's going. Neil, you brother.
Where is it?
Yeah,
he's on.
He's on. There we go, Neil's rod's going. I'm trying to unhook one. I've T-barred my little eel off. Let's go see what Neil's got.
All the same stamp.
They're all the same,
moment,
yeah,
though,
they're all a bit small, aren't they?
Yeah.
Big ones will come.
Yeah.
I'm sure. It must have had about 10 eel today. We just cannot sit down and get a break. Oh, now I've got a bite on my little rod. Here's the eel. There he is. Get the T-bar. One T-bar. There you are. I might be able to grab one for you.
There you are. Yeah.
Oh no! He's in the boat!
He'll win the boat!
Let's get him. Get out, you bagger. See you later. Just winding in my flapper rig. Have you ever heard of a flatfish mackerel? Because something has done lethalness to that. They've literally eaten everything out and just left the head. He done me right in. Right, I'm going to get a big pouch flapper on now and try that.
Well. Oh. Oh my. This is a decent fish. This is what we was waiting for.
It is, isn't it?
This is what we was waiting for.
We were just filleting the cod from we had earlier. We were just looking at its stomach contents and the clicker went off. It was a mackerel head, wasn't it?
Yeah.
Yeah. Excellent.
We might need that, this gap. Might need that gap for this one.
Yeah. Fantastic. God, he's no stopping him, is there? No stopping him.
Oh, oh my goodness. Send help. We need more crew. Neil's still into his really big conger. And now I'm into my big conger. Oh, here. Yeah. Let's put that click on so you can hear it. Okay. Oh well. No clicker for you guys, I'm afraid. But, ooh.
What a day.
What a day, man.
What a day.
Jules giving in?
Yeah. Oh, that's all right. He's coming now.
Oh. Back pad. Oh, we did a back pad. Beer man.
You're better, aren't they? We said they were going to come on the feed a bit.
Oh, there he comes. There he comes. I can see him.
He's
a, oh, he's a 20 pounder.
He's a 20 pounder, really.
He's a 20 pounder.
His eel is staying very deep. Sort of using the using my thumb to slow him down on the spool a little bit at times, but really it's just hold on and wear him out. Probably going to be my biggest sea fish I've ever caught. Oh, oh no, the other rod is having a little inquiry. Oh no, goodness me. Look at that conger, boys. That is 20 pound, good 20 pound.
That's a good 20 pound all day, that
yeah.
one.
Yeah. Woo! I'm still onto mine. Multitasking, camera in, fighting fish, trying to get good content. I reckon this could be a 30 pounder, to be honest with you. It just will not come up. Christ almighty.
The other one's going.
No, that's what I said.
Oh my God, the other one.
They must have come out of oil, must
they? Yeah, they must have done. That
said it's got to them. Yeah, they're right. Jake.
Oh,
no.
You're
going to have to strike into that one. Jake. Quadruple run. Quadruple run.
Oh, this is a big one as well. This is a big glunker as well, I think.
Oh, Christ. Gained a bit of line in it, but not a lot. Not a lot. Now, I go to the gym a lot, and I can tell you, my arms are aching. I might not have done as much gym as I used to, but I still go 3 or 4 times a week. And, yeah, I'm all in this baby, and it's very difficult. Oh, goodness me. Oh, I'll get back to you in a little while.
Yeah, no, 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 no. Yeah. You're shaking.
I'm shaking, Bill. I'm shaking, boy. Oh, look my it, God, look at him.
Oh, my God.
I don't know if you can see him.
He's wrapped himself up, hasn't he?
Yeah, yeah, somehow, hasn't he? He's big, though. He's probably 30, 40 pounds. Christ. That is a gigantic conger. He's wrapped himself up a few times, so we'll have to recover him, but he's big.
He's big, isn't he?
Yeah.
It's thick, isn't it?
Yeah, he's... Yeah,
shall I gaff him?
Yeah. Oh, he's taken it out of me, I'll tell ya. Right, let's get that gear.
Yeah. I didn't want to do it, but...
No, we're going to have to, for his sake.
For his sake and our sake.
Yeah, exactly. There we go, we'll sort him out. We've got to stand on a box, boys, to weigh this monstrosity of a conger.
Right, 35,
37. 35, lovely.
Right.
There. You got him?
Yeah, I got him.
Got him?
Yep, yep, yep.
We're good.
There you go, boys. 35 pound conger. He's 6 foot plus. Woo! Look at him. Absolute beast. We'll, I'm gonna just try and get it out for the camera for you. Right, I'm gonna get him back.
Yep.
Yep.
Jesus, man.
Go. There he goes.
He's gone.
Look at that. What a release. What a release.
What a release.
Down he goes to the deeps. 35 pound conger, that's my PB, that's the biggest shawfish. Look at that. That's the man. He's the man to thank, not me. That's my rigs, but it's his boat and he's been very kind to take me out, so. Oh, we've done well, haven't we? Right, let's get these rigs sorted because I don't think we've got any rods in the water at the moment.
What a day.
Awesome.
We had a codling off there, about 3 pound. Nice bream off there as well. And we've had, how many?
12.
We've had 12 congers and the biggest one was 35 pound. So far.
Right, we're into another fish, boys, another fish. Have a little spook strap in it.
Yeah.
I don't know how far, if he's going to be able to T-bar him. Or what, let's have a look. Yeah, stick a T-bar in there, we'll see what we can do, but there you go, another conger. Look at Neil's bait, boys. That, even I would have that for breakfast. Squid mackerel cocktail. Get it out there, fella. That deserves an 80 pounder. Right, so we've got a special concoction here, which is like a ground bait spawn, basically, for the sea. We've got a load of arable stuff in there. We're coming sort of vaguely towards the end of the session. We're going to get it in and then we're going to get launched out and hopefully that'll bring the congers on the feed and we'll get a couple more before we go. So let's give it a go. There you go. Look at that. And you just close it up and it goes down. There we go. Right, we picked something out on the lure rod. Not with a lure on it. It had a bit of squid on. But he's coming in relatively easily. But oh. Here he comes, what is he? Dogfish? Dogfish. A dogfish, eh? I'm almost relieved. Because I couldn't be dealing with a fight on a small rod with a big fish, to be honest. That old dogfish, that's for sure. Right, so we're on our way in now. We've had a fantastic day. Bream, cod, pouting, conger and dogfish. What more could we ask for? I've got a PB conger at 35 pound. Neil had a lovely mid 20. Yeah, fantastic. The wind picked up at the end and I have got work, so I'm gonna go home, get some dinner. I might have time for a shower. I probably should have one. And then head off to work. Hope you enjoyed it. Hopefully we'll do it again sometime. And, Bad boy, my recipe. Being nice, a little boring when you in between the sheep. When I ride a heat, you know I know how to please ya. Ooh, I like them tattoos and them gold teeth. Top to make me feel like I'm a baddie. I like the fire bringing out of me. Baby, something bad and got me weak in the knees. Oh, that you guys, you be criminal. My mama won't see what I see, ya. But I don't want it if it ain't bad enough. I don't know what it is. I like a bad, bad, bad.